coming up on Shawele Road.
Hello there, I am Dickson Wasake, a slave of Jesus the Christ. Now in March 2017, my life was turned upside down. Or was it right side up? You see, I had spent over 20 years in rebellion against God, the one who is known as Elohim, until I had a radical encounter with his son, Jesus Christ. By his spirit, I repented of my many sins. I got baptized shortly thereafter, and during the years that I have walked with Jesus as his servant, I have seen that the Bible which I had read is actually true, and the Lord has been faithful to me. He has answered more than 70 of my prayers, which I recorded as he commanded me. These prayers, many of them are miracles. Then towards the end of 2021, the Lord actually commissioned me to prepare a series of 12 messages called Catch the Revival. Now, this message about miracles, signs, wonders, tongues, prophecies, being slain in the spirit, and such things that happen in revival actually scared me for a second when I saw that I had to cover it this month in message number 9 of this series. I thought, but I have never raised the dead. I have never had blind eyes opened. Demons have never been cast out. Lord, why would you give me an impossible message to preach? Thank God the Lord calmed me down and he actually reminded me of someone who went before me, a prophet called Elijah. Now this prophet here told a king called Ahab, go get something to eat and drink, for I hear a mighty rainstorm coming. But this storm, which was expected after 3 years of drought, hadn't come yet. The prophet, meanwhile, is speaking in the past tense. What did Elijah do after he spoke this word to King Ahab? I am going to tell you about it. But the Lord has used this example and others to give me 3 lessons that he wants me to share with you about miracles. It will cover the secret place from which miracles come, the types of miracles, the 2 types of miracles that we typically see, and why some do not see miracles today. Come along with me to hear from the Lord. So lesson number 1 is about the secret place. But as a by the way, if you really want to know about this man Elijah I'm going to speak about, you could go to message number 8 that I recorded on humility and learn about this amazing man. Nevertheless, in this miracle of rain that we are going to study, this is what the Bible says. Then Elijah said to Ahab, go get something to eat and drink, for I hear a mighty rainstorm coming. So Ahab went to eat and drink. But Elijah climbed to the top of Mount Carmel and bowed low to the ground and prayed with his face between his knees. Then he said to his servant, go and look out toward the sea. The servant went and looked, then returned to Elijah and said, I didn't see anything. 7 times Elijah told him to go and look. Finally, the 7th time, his servant told him, I saw a little cloud about the size of a man's hand rising from the sea. Then Elijah shouted, hurry to Ahab and tell him, climb into your chariot and go back home. If you don't hurry, the rain will stop you. And soon the sky was black with clouds. A heavy wind brought a terrific rainstorm, and Ahab left quickly for Jezreel. So the Lord is actually showing us from this story that the miracle of rain was actually born in the secret place of prayer. Ahab the king was eating and drinking, but Elijah the prophet was on a mountain praying 7 times, persistent prayer, because the word of the Lord had come to him a long time ago that it would not rain until 3 years have passed. But he needed to pray. The first lesson on miracles, signs and wonders, therefore, is that miracles come from faith in God's word that he has previously spoken. And what we do is we grab a hold of that word and refuse to let go of it. We pray persistently, often in a secret place, until that which is already manifest in heaven becomes manifest here on the earth. Lesson number two is about quick and long miracles. These are the two types of miracles that come. So like I mentioned at the start, I actually keep track of the prayers that I pray to God. But I actually didn't realize that the 70 answered prayers of mine are actually miracles. You see, I thought I had actually never experienced miracles, and it took the Lord, the gracious Lord, to actually show me that I've experienced many. And even more so, just before I prepared this message, the Lord actually got me to review my prayer journal, and I didn't realize there's even one particular instance I had recorded deliberately as a miracle. Let me share with you actually what I wrote. These are excerpts of it. 30th June 2021, a miracle happened today. Our flight from Minnesota St. Paul to Chicago O'Hare at 1524 was wildly delayed, and when it finally took off and we were in the air, the pilot announced there might be a further potential delay, and we were in a holding pattern due to a storm over Chicago. There was a possibility we wouldn't land, and so we would have to turn around and go back or land in another airport. I was so worked up, I prayed furiously to the Lord and prayed a prayer of faith and told God to clear the storm so we could land. I called on Him and said His word is we can tell mountains to move. I stood confidently on faith and over told the storm to clear in Jesus' name. I couldn't believe my ears. 5 minutes later, the pilot said the storm was cleared and we could land. I burst into tears and felt the chatter of the Spirit. I was so full of joy. Something has changed, Lord, for it's the year of mountain-moving faith, and you have showed me what furious prayer can do. Lord, thank you for this wonderful testimony. From this testimony, I have actually realized this revelation from the Lord. Miracles are two types. The first, the types of what we often call miracles, these ones happen instant or quick. These are the ones such as raising the dead. And then the second type are the ones which come as a result of a life devoted to prayer over a longer period. These are the bulk of the ones I have recorded. The other revelation is miracles nevertheless happen all the time, for God is often working in the life of His faithful servants, but He often works in the background, silently, and unless you keep track of what He's doing, you might not see what God has done to answer your miracles. If you keep a spiritual record of what God is doing, it will show you the miracles in your life, as He has taught me. Then, for these miracles that happen instantly, they require a passionate prayer, often a giant prayer of faith, where you won't let go of the Lord until He literally breaks through the storm, as my testimony and example showed. Lesson number three is very important. Why don't we see miracles today? Now, for this, I turned to a modern day revivalist and an evangelist called Daniel Colender. Their ministry is called Christ for All Nations. It has recorded over 83 million salvation decisions to date. Now, Daniel is the successor of the late evangelist Reinhard Bonnke. And Daniel's ministry, like that of his predecessor Bonnke, is full of miracles, signs, and wonders. Some have even been raised from the dead in some of their crusades, which can even have 1 million people at a time. When he was asked why some do not see miracles today, he responded as follows. If you don't pray for dead people, you'll never see one raised. If you don't preach the gospel, you'll never see someone saved. If you don't lay hands on the sick, you won't see any of them healed. If you don't rebuke demons, you'll never cast one out. You've got to go. You've got to take action in Jesus' name. So going and preaching the good news is actually the secret to what brings miracles to follow as Daniel was driving at. And the Bible confirms this. The Bible shows this. Jesus sent out the 12 apostles with these instructions. Don't go to the Gentiles or the Samaritans, but only to the people of Israel, God's lost sheep. Go and announce to them that the kingdom of heaven is near. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cure those with leprosy, and cast out demons. Give as freely as you have received. So what we see is miracles, signs, wonders, prophecies, tongues, laying in the spirit that often happen in revivals are all a sign. A sign of what? They are a sign that the kingdom of heaven has come near. They are a sign that the King of heaven, Jesus, has come near. It is why for us to catch the revival, the gospel should be preached. Signs and wonders will then follow the preaching of the gospel, which means good news. This Lord Jesus who I've spoken about, who is he and what did he actually tell me to tell you for this message? He told me to tell you that God shows no favoritism, and from every nation he accepts those who fear him and do what is right. For those who are seeking God's friendship, if you're seeking God's peace, he has anointed a man called Jesus. This Jesus came to this earth and he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by Satan. He was, however, killed by those who hated him. But God raised him from the dead after 3 days, just as many prophets had prophesied for thousands of years before his birth. This Jesus is now seated at the right hand of God Almighty, Elohim, and it is he who God, the Ancient of Days, has appointed as the righteous judge over the living and the dead. And he is the one with the power to forgive all our sins. Everyone who believes this message that we preach, as he has commanded me, and everyone who accepts that this Jesus is Lord and asks for forgiveness, they will receive this forgiveness and they will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, who God has promised to all who believe in Jesus, his Son. Do you believe this? Do you want God's forgiveness? Do you want to be at peace with God? If you have never made this Jesus your Lord, come. Come, he says. Come, pray this prayer with me if you've never prayed it before. God of heaven, I confess that I am a sinner, and I have been one since birth. But I have heard that you can make me new, and you sent your Son Jesus to die for me. He rose again, and it is he who can give me his Holy Spirit. Please forgive me and welcome me into your kingdom. Teach me how to follow you. In Jesus' name, amen. I welcome you into the kingdom of our Lord. And for those of you who are already believers, may I pray this prayer of revival over you. O Lord God, give us the faith to believe your word, that we may see miracles, signs, and wonders in our generation. Revive us, Lord. Let us catch your revival. Amen. Now I have some next steps for you who have become new believers. Number one, publicly demonstrate the proof of your getting saved by actually getting baptized. This means of publicly declaring your acceptance of Jesus is for all of you who believe, because the Lord says if you are ashamed of him, he will also be ashamed of you before his Father and the angels. The second thing is start living a life of faith as a Christian. And this starts by reading the Bible, just like I did, praying and finding a church or a Christian community to walk with you. Now, don't you worry. God, the Holy Spirit, who started this journey with you, will remain with you to get to finish the work, because the Lord Jesus says, I am with you until the end of all time. Now, if you have a local church to attend, please do attend it. If, however, you do not have one, you're welcome to join our online church. And actually, we have a great gift for you. If you subscribe to our newsletter, you will also receive a free book that is called Holding On to Christ, that the Lord got me to write. You will also receive a 1-year spiritual guide that will be regular messages to help you hold on to Christ and to stay on track. If you have questions, if you have prayer requests, write to me and I will pray for you, Father. There's just one thing that is left. Stick around for our information notice board. and get some next steps. Lord Jesus, Maranatha.
And here is the information notice board. Pray for us. Without the Lord, our effort is in vain. Pray that we remain faithful, humble servants. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and keep up with our videos which support the website. Looking for a ministry to partner with? Pray, volunteer, give, subscribe to. Consider supporting. The above ministry website has not paid us to provide this recommendation, and so the views expressed here do not necessarily represent the views of the ministry promoted above. Likewise, the views therein do not necessarily reflect those of this ministry. So here are your next steps. I believe.